In today's class, I am going to teach you a construction of hyperbola. Before going to study construction of hyperbola, let's look at the question. It belongs to which method? You have to identify it belongs to which method if it is not given in the question. Now let's look at the problem. The distance from directrix to focus is 50. Draw the hyperbola, use it eccentricity method, and also locate tangent and normal at any point on the curve. By looking at the question, it is very easy to understand it is of eccentricity method which is directly given in the problem. There is no confusion. Whereas if you have gone through my earlier videos, ellipse as well as parabola, there was like E value is given and trace the curve and name the curve. The question will be varied, but it is just simple problem directly understandable to each and every student in which method it should be drawn. First thing is eccentricity method. That means I am going to draw this E method. For hyperbola, E is greater than 1. I hope you know that. E is greater than 1. Next. What are the points to be known and identified? Mark here is the distance from directrix. Focus. Yes, students, if eccentricity method term is also not given in the problem, if directrix and the focus comes in the question, it by default it is nothing but eccentricity method. By default, it is nothing but eccentricity method. Now I am going to trace hyperbola. Now, the construction steps are similar to that of parabola as well as hyperbola. Now, what exactly directrix is? I repeat once again, directrix is also called as fixed straight line. Directrix is also called as fixed straight line. And whereas focus is nothing but fixed point. Fixed point. The distance given is 50. So in order to trace the problem, first, I need to locate a horizontal line as directrix and perpendicular to this a vertical line which is nothing but axis. Axis line passing or perpendicular to the directrix axis. On axis we need to locate focus, I mean fixed point, and this is called as directrix. This directrix is otherwise called as fixed straight line. It's a fixed straight line. A line perpendicular to directrix is nothing but axis. Now let me give a name to this. Let this be A and B and C as well as D. My AB is axis line and CD is directrix or fixed straight line. Now when you look into the question, distance from directrix to focus is 50. From directrix, focus is a point located on the axis, so it is at a distance of 50. Let this be F. So my AF is nothing but 50. That is nothing but the distance from directrix to focus is 50. Next. What we need to do the next point, which is similar to that of hyperparabola as well as ellipse. I need to locate the vertex. Next point is to locate the vertex. What is a vertex? Vertex is a point where the curve is passing through axis. Vertex is a point where the curve is touching the axis, and a point is called as a vertex. Now how to get the vertex? By the term E, eccentricity. As eccentricity is greater than 1, here if you plot them, they will be giving E is 3 by 2 or just they may not give. See here the problem, eccentricity method was given just directly hyperbola. Then how much, at which point I need to locate the vertex? At what point I need to locate the vertex is the question. So take the fraction decimal which is greater than 1, either 3 by 2 or 4 by 3 or 2 by 1 is nothing but 2 by 1 is greater than 1. Similarly, I am considering 3 by 2. Consider or assuming my E value is 3 by 2 which is greater than 1. Yes, so which is greater than 1. Now, what exactly an eccentricity is, as we discussed yesterday and previous class also, the distance from vertex to focus, focus to vertex, and vertex to directrix. This is nothing but VF by VA. VF by VA. Eccentricity is defined as the ratio of point to, or point to focus, point to directrix, or vertex to focus, or vertex to directrix. Now, what is this? How to divide this? AF, 3 plus 2. 3 plus 2, numerator and denominator is 5. That means I am going to make 5 equal divisions between A to F. Between A to F, I am going to divide between 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, and that is 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 plus 3 plus 2 is 5. Where I am looking the vertex? If you look, B to F is 3 divisions and B to A is 2 divisions. So, if I look from here, A, this is 0, so 1, 2, so this is my vertex, second position, the denominator value. Or, if you read from the focus, that is 3, so this is 0, so this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so I need to locate a third division, as it is 0, 1, 2, 3, third division. If you read from either this side or this side, vertex will be at the same position, location, that is 3 by 2. What is the next step, students? VF is nothing but VF is equals to VE. I need to locate a moving point so that I should measure VF value and draw a perpendicular line to the axis. That is nothing but VE. VF equals to VE. Next, join A to E and extend it further, the line of any length. Extending it further. What I have done after looking at the vertex, VF equals to VE, and from A, draw a line meeting E and extend that line. Next step. What is the next step? Similar to that of the other problems which we have done, divide number of lines to the next of B which need not be of equidistance. What is the next step? After the vertex, divide a set of points on the axis which need not be of equal distance, or is up to you, you can make equal distance also. Next, draw perpendiculars to the axis from this point and touching a line. I mean, just draw a line above and below and extend it down. Similarly, extend all these lines as you are going to do with engineering drafter. You may be getting exact perfect lines as I am using a free hand, so my lines may not be straight and the drawing is also not to the scale. So all my drawings are not to the scale, so you have to use your instruments to get exact diagram. Now I give a name to this. This is 1 and this will be 1 dash. Similarly, 1, 2, 3, 4. So let this be 4, and this is 4 dash, and 5, 6, and this is 6 dash. It doesn't mean, students, you have to draw only 6 points, you can draw any number of points. The more number of points you draw, the more number of points you will be getting very smooth curve, as this is a freehand curve. Next, what is next? I need to trace the curve now. In order to trace the curve, my 1, 1 dash, 2, 2 dash, so on, will be the same radius. Radius, all these points are radius, and F, focus is center, F as center, F as center, cutting either sides. My F is here. You can take even on F also in line, it is up to you, whether it is up to you now. 1 dash as radius with your engineering compass, F as center, cutting either sides of the arc. Which arc measurement you are taking? Take it on to F and cut that arc above and below. Above and below. Similarly, next go to second. 2 to dash is a radius, F as a center, cutting second line. Next, this is 3, 3 dash is radius, F as center, cutting
third third line. Similarly, proceed with same 4 4 dash above and below, whereas F is center. Next 5 5 dash is as center. So, similarly, proceed students with this. So, join all this. This means this is my P1. This is P1 and this is P1 dash. Similarly, this is P6. This point is on 6th line. So, I got a point. Generated a point above and below. So, this is 6 dash. So, this is 6 dash. Then, join all this from the vertex. Curve starts from the vertex. Just draw them. And in a single stroke, taking HB pencil, please join it, making a rectic line. In a single stroke, HB pencil. You try to sharpen your pencil from time to time to give you a smooth curve. So, this is what you will be getting exact an open curve bit. Make inside and open into your enlarged curve. As my drawing is not the scale, it may sometimes look like parabola, but this is not a parabola, this is hyperbola. So if you work exactly the scale, you will be getting a very neat curve which is of hyperbola nature. So this basis. Next. He's also asked in the question to draw tangent to normal at any point in the curve. Trace a tangent and normal using a scale from the directrix. Locate a point at some distance. It's asked to draw anywhere. So my point is, for example, here. So similar method. This has my M. So join this M to F. Join this M to F. Next, MF, perpendicular line. Draw a perpendicular line to MF 90 degree. So this may be reaching either above or below. And name this as T, the point T. Then HB pencil directly draw the line from T touching M, passing through it. So this is T and this is my T dash. So T T dash is tangent. T T dash is tangent. This is a vertex. Tangent. And perpendicular to tangent, 90 degree from this point is normal. So this is N, N dash. So I have taken a point at some distance when it is not asking the problem where I need to draw. You can draw anywhere, either here, 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 or anywhere. Take a point, take it as M, join it to F, draw a perpendicular line to MF. So that will be here, touching here, whatever it is touching the name. So from that, draw a line by passing through M. So that T dash is a tangent, perpendicular to tangent, 90 degrees is a normal. This is what I told you. No, try to write compulsory E value that is greater than 1 or whatever it is, E value which you have chosen here, that is 3 by 2 is here. Next, finally, you need to furnish even the dimensioning. Dimensioning plays a vital role in engineering drawing. Without dimensioning or without geometry, we are not going to construct any problems in engineering graphics. So the distance from directrix to focus is given, that is 50. This is 50. Dear students, I hope you are getting my lectures, the concepts. Please work in your drawing sheets regularly. For more videos, please kindly subscribe to my channel.